So we're on to heat two of the men's eight. Great Britain in lane number three. Just give you a quick order. Top of the picture there in lane one, Canada, Australia. We're looking at them now in lane number two. Just the last few minutes. Focusing the mind. It's going to be a real humdinger this race. Great Britain will be in lane number three alongside this white boat from Australia. There's Rowley Douglas. The black boat, the traditional black boat now of the British guys. Fred Scarlett there, we're looking down the boat. Kieran West, his birthday today. What a present that would be if he won this opening heat. Luca Gruber, Lewis Attrell, Simon Dennis, Ben Hunt Davis. And in the bows, Andrew Lindsay. All fantastic athletes. This is a real technical boat now. So they're just sitting ready for the starter to call them under orders. Canada now being called forwards. Everyone sitting forwards, waiting for the call.
Attention.
Green lights, they're away. First time, watch the bows of the black boat. It's off sharp, it's fast. They're up now on 49 strokes per minute. Fantastically good in the first three or four strokes there. But the race between Great Britain and Australia in lane number two. Australia second now at Lucerne Regatta. They've gone off at 50 and a half, and Great Britain were first. So it's first and second from Lucerne. Well, let's see how the crews have done, Dan, over the last two, 3 months' preparation.
Absolutely right, because the Australians, this is their home water, their home crowd. They will be really geared up for this. But remember, yesterday we had Australia being put into second place by British crews in the four and in the pair. Let's see if the British eight can make that a hat-trick. But this is very, very important for them. Russia's gone off well as well on down the bottom of the picture there. The Russians, who were Olympic bronze medalists 4 years ago, they're always good performers at the Olympics. And they row well, they're very well disciplined, and they're an experienced crew. Very little change from the crew that won that bronze medal before.
They're also bronze medalists from the World Championships last year, so loads of experience in this boat, and it really is an event that you can't afford just to paddle out to 1,000 and see where you are. You've got to go right from the first stroke, and it's about racing for lanes if you're not winning. But the early form at the moment is Great Britain in third place, Australia in lane two first, and Canada up there having a flyer in the first 500 metres. Andrew Lindsay in the bow seat, but just look across the boats. Yeah, Great Britain will look relaxed. They will look smooth and they will look relaxed, and they'll be okay. They're fine there. They're just a quarter of a length down on Australia. Australians down have to get out quick in the first 500 metres. They really have to be up to establish, and that's what they're trying to do in this boat.
Well, they do like to be ahead, and this is just where they like to be, the Australians. I think Britain, though, has checked them, and they're just beginning to edge back a bit here.
So at the first quarter mark in the second heat of the men's eight, Great Britain in third place, but they're just down a little bit. There's not too much to worry about. But Mick Mackay in the middle of the Australian boats, he's part of the legendary Awesome Foursome, the Australian two times Olympic gold medalist. He's going for his third in the men's eight, two in the Coxless four. He is in the Australian boat what Tim Foster was to the British eight last year. So he'll be urging his boys on now, and Great Britain coming into rhythm, and they're taking on Canada. And they may well be through Canada in a couple of strokes, but the early form, Australia, lane two.
Yeah, they're moving very well there. There's one change in the boat there, two changes in the boat. There's Andrew Lindsay at the bow, who's come into the seat there, and instead of Bobby Thatcher, and Tim Foster has been replaced by Simon Dennis, who was in the pair. But at the moment, leading the field is Australia. The British know them well. They know they've got a job to do here. This is very, very important.
Comparison of heat times, Croatia 122, Croatia 120, Australia 122. And we're at the halfway mark in this heat. The second heat, the opening account for Great Britain in the black boat. They're in lane number three, and they're currently in third place. Still looking very comfortable. We're just looking there at Steve Tramore, sets up a fantastic rhythm. And Rowley Douglas is a real inspirer, a real motivator. Now the British through 1,100 metres. Here they go. They're pushing on now. They've increased their rate up to 37 and a half strokes per minute. They're starting to challenge. We had Australia a quarter of a length lead. Now it's down to a canvas. Look at that. Two and three. Here come the black boats.
They're technically very, very accomplished, the British boat. Look how relaxed that is. They're very, very smooth. They're very, very accurate at the front end of the stroke. They pick it up there with the legs. Australia really holding them off there. If they can put pressure now on the Australians, that's where the race will really be decided. It's now just about 700 metres to go.
So Australia looking strong. Mick Mackay in the middle of the boat there with the glasses on. He's in the five seat, urging his boys on, pushing them on. And Australia now out to half a length, and the crowd are really going wild. Great Britain have got the measure of Canada. Canada slipping back to third place, but the British crew up on 37 now. They've got to respond. It's very important for the British crew to go through to the heat. They don't reach to the final. They do not want to race the repechage. But with 500 metres to go in the second heat, men's eight. Australia half a length now from Great Britain in the black boat. Great Britain have looked leisurely in the first 1500 metres, Dan. They've really got to push on now.
This is where it counts. They've got to turn it on, and they've gone up now to 39. Australia looking very determined, very horizontal the way they row, very good drive of the legs. Australia are going to find, they're not going to let this go. The British crew now winding it up, they're nearly up to 40 now. They're really trying to move back. It's half a length though, this is going to be tough for them. Very tough indeed.
Every time the British crew push, the Australians are responding, and the seven man there from the Australian, Burke, urging his boys on. You can see now that the black boat is pushing and pushing, but they're strong with 250 metres to go. It's three quarters of a length, Australia, and the British boat now up on 39 strokes per minute. Here they're pushing, they've got 200 metres. Have they got enough to get through? Australia holding three quarters of a length. The British boat have got the measure of Canada, and the crowd are absolutely going mad for the home team here. Australia pushing on, three quarters of a length on the black boat. Great Britain in second place. Great Britain on 38 strokes. Australia holding it. We've got 100 metres to the line. The crowd pushing and urging Australia back. And Great Britain respond. They're coming up to half a length, but with about five or six strokes remaining in the second heat of the men's eights, it's going Australia's way. Well, there's a surprise. On the line, Australia half a length. Great Britain second place. And the arms once again go in the air from the Australians. They'll be very happy with that. In such an absolute tight and very competitive field, a very competitive event, Australia 1.5 boat length a lead over Great Britain.